What up guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and we're going to use some very simple editing techniques that actually look amazing. This episode is sponsored by Videoblocks, the cheapest stock and video effects library I know of. And that's because Videoblocks doesn't take any percent from its creators. So whether you need a stock clip, a nice looking background, or a logo reveal animation, the one-time price you pay per year gets evenly distributed among those creators and nobody else. Definitely make sure to check it out, guys. Visit the first link in the description below. You might have seen it before, a dolly zoom effect. What you do is sliding your camera backwards or forwards, and while doing that, you also make sure that you zoom your lens and try to keep the same frame size. But what if you're on a drone or you want to create this effect on a clip where you didn't zoom? Well, here's how it's done. I filmed Janik while I was walking slowly backwards. For smoother motion, you can of course use a slider. Then inside Adobe Premiere Pro, I animate the scale property of that clip and make sure that the framing on the end of the clip is the same as in the beginning. And that's the only thing that you need to do to make it work. Now, talking about keyframes, the next thing is something extremely powerful yet super simple. When you create an animation inside Premiere Pro, it will not look so natural by default. What you should always do is to make sure that your animation starts slowly and ends slowly. Now, this can be done by right-clicking on your keyframe, go to Temporal Interpolation, and choose Easy Ease Out for your starting animation. And for the last keyframe, you do the same thing, but choose Ease In. Your animation will now instantly look a lot better, and I do this with almost any keyframe that I place. And for those that like to have even more control over their keyframes, you can actually open up the property that you've animated from the left. You can then see a curve which represents the speed of the keyframe. If you want to see an in-depth tutorial, by the way, on how that all works, you can click any cards up there. Next up, you want to film someone from a tripod and ask the person to clap their hands or snap their fingers. After that, you film the same shot without your actor. In Premiere Pro, I put the empty shot in channel number 1 and one with the actor in channel 2. Just as the person snaps their fingers, I create a cut. And that's how simple it is to teleport yourself. To take these effects to a next level though, take one shot of your actor standing on the left side and on the right side. Put them on top of each other in Premiere Pro and apply the crop effect to the one above. Crop it to the half and perhaps increase the feather a little bit. And bang, you've made a clone out of yourself. But because we filmed everything on a tripod, it's pretty static. So in the next editing trick, we'll add some fake camera movement. And the technique that I recommend is the most natural camera movement that you can get. Here's how it goes. Put a marker to the wall, like a small piece of tape. Then just film that tape handheld. In Premiere Pro, you then create a keyframe for the position and adjust for every frame. You want to make sure that the anchor point in your program monitor aligns with the marker that you filmed. Finally, increase the scaling a little bit to remove the edges and then select the motion on top and copy that. On your actual static clip, you can then simply select it and paste the motion. And that will copy all of those keyframes from your natural handheld movement. If you have multiple layers, like the previous trick, you can select them all, right-click and say Nest. On that group, you then paste the keyframes. And the final editing hack for today is inspired by an older video from Film Riot. We actually made a video about how to punch someone in the face, and many of you guys were actually mentioning a great additional tip that came from Film Riot. To increase the power of punching someone, you can simply remove one frame right before the actor hits the subject or the wall. So we're not speeding up the clip, but it does feel that way on the moment the impact happens. Do you know about any other great editing tips? Well then let us know in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching, but most importantly, stay creative. Hey guys, this right here is AndyX. Anders from AndyX.
That changed, yeah.
Yeah. What up guys, this right here is Anders from AndyX. We are here at IBC 2017.
Hello guys, this is AndyX and this is Jordan. We are going to